This is Chris Gilchrist, breakdancer, urban art lover, and entrepreneur. Chris founded a successful entertainment enterprise that is encouraging young volunteers across Devon and challenging people to think outside of the box about what volunteering is. Though his shoes are indeed wide and shiny, what you might not know is that Chris wasn't always the successful young person he is now, but grew up at risk in the city of Plymouth. This is his story.
Right, we're in Neswick Street, which is Stonehouse, the area I grew up in. Fine place to play in Neswick Street Park. Used to cause a lot of mischief in there. There was late night shouting, making a lot of noise, winding up all the old people. This is where I started going to secondary school. And it was an old house, it was all right. That's my bedroom just up there. When we was living here, I wasn't the best behaved kid in school. I was suspended a lot, was always fighting. Thing is though, you could say I was like one of those naughty kids that the teachers sort of respected, because I always put my hand up when I was wrong. But I just, there's a pain in the neck as well. We used to hang about around here and just cause loads of trouble. I remember a time I threw a glass bottle through that window up there just because I was bored. I was about 10. But if you look here, my name used to be right across here in the, where you see it from the white paint. My mum opened our door, because we used to live there. She opened the door and just seen bright orange letters, Gilchrist, right across the wall. Now obviously it was me, so it was pretty suspicious. So she made me come out here in the middle of the day, Saturday daytime, with all my friends playing football in the park, like running around the streets doing what they do. She made me sit here with a white paint can and paintbrush, and she made me paint a big square over my name, just so it looked better than Gilchrist, the big orange white letters. Can you believe that?
What does it all mean?
Drinking, stealing and vandalism are all regular things for children growing up on these streets. But Chris channeled the boredom and restlessness into breakdancing. It was at a local youth centre that Chris started learning, practicing every Friday night rather than being on the streets and getting into trouble.
This place here helped out a lot, which is the Frederick Street Centre. Although it's not under the same management now as it was, which is a shame because all the old youth workers were legends. I mean, it's all different people come down here now, so it's a training this whole year. Every Friday night, which was ideal, never charged us anything, which is awesome. A lot of kids in areas like this grew up to just end up doing nothing, getting into drugs or stealing cars and doing things like that. Well, I never did any of that, so still nice. It's not as bad as it would like to be. I look at me, I tell it, because I try to give people a chance. So.
It wasn't soon after Chris taught himself how to break dance that the neighbourhood children came to watch him and others as they practiced. It was to these children watching in amazement that Chris first started to teach and help other young people who were in the same situation he was.
Right, well, this is where I started training when I was breakdancing. On this tarmac, without lino, many times I used to cut my arms up and graze myself, that's because we couldn't afford lino, it was unbelievable. But then when the Frederick Street got involved, they helped us buy some, and we moved from the tarmac to the football pitch. So we moved to concrete with lino. But when we used to practice in here, just like any day after school, Saturdays and Sundays, and you see all the young kids that come out from the ages here, come out from flats and all over, and used to watch us, and some of them would ask us to teach them, so we'd start teaching them a few little moves and get them doing some of it. But I suppose it was that sort of made me realise teaching kids what I do is a good thing. I mean, because they could have been out stealing someone's car or throwing milk bottles through windows, but they weren't. They were in this park dancing with me, so I suppose that's sort of what made me start thinking it's a good thing, because I was doing the same thing as well. I could have been out fighting and robbing shops, you know, robbing Christian shops and stuff, but I didn't. This is where it all started. There's a bit of time back, we're here.
After school, in the evenings and over weekends, Chris and his friends spent all their time breakdancing at whatever they knew they could get, even in the school gym. It was over the coming years that the first signs of reward came to his hard work and dedication by getting involved with Millennium Volunteers.
Well, after a few years of dancing and teaching and stuff like that, I realised getting into it more would be what I want to do, so I started getting into voluntary work when I heard about Millennium Volunteers, which I heard about it in Frederick Street because I had someone come pay me a visit and explain a few things to me. So we did that, And through that, I managed to get my Millennium Volunteers Award. And then from then on, I sort of built up a reputation amongst all the youth clubs in Plymouth and all the youth services. And they started getting me in to do workshops for them. So from that, you can sort of say I've built myself a kind of career. It's made me realise what I want to do in life, which is open my own dance school.
Chris formed Beatbreaker Entertainment to train young people in urban arts, many of whom were coming from similar backgrounds as him. For most of these young people, this would be what kept them off the streets and out of the prisons.
First time I've seen Beatbreakers must have been a show at Respect Festival, first year they did it. Joined Beatbreakers, or I went to a few of their like training sessions, ended up joining them after trial. Been happy days since. If I wasn't doing anything with my dance and Beatbreakers right now, I'd probably be average Plymouth scrote, hanging around, couple of tinnies, big ass split. But happy days again, I'm in a big crew, and we're going further.
Beatbreakers now attracts urban artists of all kinds. This promotional video is made to show how diverse and how relevant the team has become.
We've gone from being just breakdancers to being an all-round urban arts group. Urban arts is sort of street arts, I would say. Street dancers, a rapper, we got singers, human beatboxers, street ball players, a free runner, and a DJ.
Beatboxing is basically imitating sounds of the mouth. For example, like a drum sound or sound effects. Just silly noises, basically.
Beatbreakers entertainers were invited to the Vanquish Christmas party because we did their second magazine launch party and it went mad.
This Christmas, the beat-breaking team are the headlining act for the switching on of the Christmas lights in Plymouth. It's a big event with an expected crowd of over 8,000 people and nerves are high.
What's good, people? Chris here, beat-breakers. Better go on stage for the big switch on of Plymouth's Christmas lights. Headlining act this year, the last act on before the lights get switched on. Just brought Bad Lashes from X Factor in here. We're gonna be a cracking show. We're gonna tear it up, beat-breaker style, as usual. Yeah, keep tuning, you'll see the show. It'll be awesome. Brilliant.
Fancy seeing the Beatbreakers tonight? Boo, 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 boo! DJ Bell Bell! Bell's remix! Let's go!
Bye.
crowd. Ready? 1, 2, 3. And let's have a wee love beat breakers from you all too. 1, 2, 3. And beat breakers, love you. Have a great night. You've got bad lasses coming up onto the stage. Thank you very much. Make some noise for the beat breakers.
It's been awesome. We finished the show. Massive applause. I mean, they loved those. They were chanting beat breakers and everything, so that was awesome. Beat breakers, where is it now in 2008? Well, since 2002, we've come a long way. Now we are at the stage where we've expanded quite big, going from a breakdance crew to a whole hip-hop crew. We're like now trying to turn something we started as a hobby to keep us out of trouble, keep us busy, into a living, a business, something we can push to show that, I mean, you don't have to sit on street corners drinking, causing trouble. The fact that that's all because of something I did, I don't think you'd get a better feeling in the world, to be honest with you. Apart from having your own kid, I don't think you'd ever get a better feeling in the world than that. So that's what Beat Breakers has sort of led to now. QB.